Hello everyone and welcome to the science class of grade 8. So children, so far in chapter 4th, you have studied chapter 4th, metals and non-metals. You have studied about the physical properties of metals and non-metals. Then you have studied about some chemical properties of metals and non-metals. How do they react with acid? How do they react with bases? And now what happens when we burn them? All those things. What happens when metal oxides and non-metal oxides are mixed with water? They create bases and acids, isn't it? So you have studied all that. And now let us come to a very interesting part. And that interesting part is the displacement reactions. Today we will study about the displacement reactions. Now what are the displacement reactions? Now this is it. If you were in the school, I would have shown it to you. But never mind, I am trying to explain it to you. Now what is a displacement reaction? Displacement matlab कोई अपनी जगह पे था, आप गया, आपने धक्का मार के उसको डिस्प्लेस कर दिया एंड यू टुक दैट पर्सन्स प्लेस, सो यू डिस्प्लेस्ड. सो सेम थिंग हैपेंस इन द मेटल्स आल्सो, है ना, दे आल्सो डिस्प्लेस ईच अदर, दे आल्सो हैव स्ट्रेंथ एंड वीकनेसेस. सो डेफिनेटली द वन विच इज स्ट्रॉन्गर विल डेफिनेटली डिस्प्लेस अ वीकर वन, isn't it? Let us study about it. You can see here, take 500 milliliter bottles, beakers, and label them. Then we have taken water and we have dissolved like this, right? Okay, now what do we see? In beaker A, we had copper sulfate solution and we added zinc granules to it. Try to understand it. It's not difficult at all, right? In beaker A, we took copper sulfate solution, we had a blue colored solution and we added zinc granules to it. Beaker B, again we took copper sulfate solution and we added iron nail, लोहे की कील टू इट. बीकर सी, वी टुक जिंक सल्फेट एंड वी एडेड कॉपर टर्निंग्स इनटू इट. कॉपर को छील के उसकी छिलकन जो होती है ना, वी एडेड दैट. बीकर डी, व्हाट डिड वी ऐड? वी ऐड आयरन सल्फेट एंड वी टुक आयरन सल्फेट एंड वी एडेड कॉपर टर्निंग्स इनटू इट. एंड इन बीकर ई, वी टुक जिंक सल्फेट एंड वी एडेड आयरन नेल. So when we added this, we got these five color solutions. In beaker A, we had blue color solution, copper sulfate. In beaker B, we had again blue color solution, copper sulfate. Beaker C, zinc sulfate tha. It is transparent whitish color. Then iron sulfate, we had that rusty, kyunki iron se rust hoti hai, hai na? So that light brownish solution. And beaker E, again it was zinc sulfate, we got that transparent whitish solution. What happened after some time? In the copper sulfate solution, we had added zinc sulfate, right? So zinc sulfate mein kya hua? Zinc ne copper ko dhakka mara aur copper sulfate ki jagah ban gaya zinc sulfate. कलर ऑफ द सोल्यूशन चेंज एंड ये नीचे कॉपर के शिलिंग्स बैठ गए, राइट? सो दिस इज व्हाट इज हैपनिंग हियर. नाउ इन द सेकेंड वन, अगेन वी हैड कॉपर सल्फेट सोल्यूशन एंड वी हैड एडेड आयरन इनटू इट, आयरन नेल. इंस्टेड ऑफ ब्लू वी हैव अ ग्रीनिश सोल्यूशन ऑफ आयरन सल्फेट. We saw the two changes, right? Then third one was zinc sulfate and we added copper turnings into it. Is there a change? No change. In beaker D, we had iron sulfate and we added copper into it. Is there a change? There is no change. In again zinc sulfate solution we have added iron. Is there a change? There is no change. So here we saw the change, and copper sulfate in both the cases is here as a residue at the bottom, and the color of the solution is also changed. But here there is no change. Why? The reason is that copper zinc pehla wala dekhte hain, chaliye zinc is more reactive than copper. Zinc is more reactive than copper, and that is why the color of the solution changed. Similarly, in the other one, iron is more reactive than copper, and that is why the color of the solution changed. Here, zinc and copper, no change means zinc is stronger than copper. So, copper could not replace zinc, and there is no change. Another, iron sulfate and copper, copper could not replace or displace iron. There is no change. In the last one, zinc sulfate and iron, iron also could not displace zinc. And hence, which is the strongest out of these? The strongest is zinc. Uske baad, next is iron. And lastly, the weakest here or the least reactive is the copper. Right? So, this is the displacement reaction where there is one more reactive metal displaces the less reactive metal, and we get a change in the new substances are formed. Chemical reaction hai. In this case, no change means there is no chemical reaction. Here, the change has taken place, and hence there is a chemical reaction, right? Let us move. So this is what is explained here. There is a equation also, copper sulfate plus zinc. We got zinc sulfate colorless hai, and copper is that red substances which are deposited in the beaker, at the bottom of the beaker, right? So in the beaker number C, D and E there is no change because there is no change because copper and iron, they are less reactive than zinc, and hence they could not displace it, right? So I am sure this is clear to you all. The way we have written for copper sulfate and zinc, similarly we can write for copper sulfate and iron. Yahan pe kya banega? Copper sulfate plus iron, we get the zinc iron sulfate and copper as a residue, right? So after this, let us know about the uses of metals and non-metals. You know, you look around you, everything has metal into it, isn't it? Everything has, even our body has metal into it. Iron is very much there in the hemoglobin. Yes or no? Otherwise, you look at the equipment or around you, you can see the usage of metals. The watch you are wearing, the watch your dad, the wristwatch that your dad is wearing, the jewelry that your mother is wearing, the pots, the utensils in which she is cooking, everything is made up of metals. Industrial gadgets, satellites, trains, aeroplanes, automobiles, machinery, cooking utensils, water boilers, all the industrial usage. Definitely we cannot live without it. Even in construction of a house or a building, we are using iron sariya. So that is used to provide strength to the building. That is why you see there are buildings which are so tall. Even in small cities, there are residential buildings, 6th floor, 8th floor, 10th floor. So what is bearing all the mass? The iron which is put inside the pillars, the concrete pillars, right? The iron is put into it. Let us know about the non-metals. Non-metal is essential for our life, in which all the living beings inhale, inhale during breathing? Of course, that is oxygen. Next is non-metal used in fertilizers to enhance the growth of the plants. Phosphorus, nitrogen, these are nitrogen, phosphorus, they are being used. Then, non-metal used in water purification processes. Of course, the soldiers, when they go to the field areas, the borders, do you think there is a water filter they carry with themselves? No, they carry chlorine tablets. In the villages, during this monsoon season, the ponds, the wells, etc., the chlorine tablets are added because it is a disinfectant, it purifies the water. In the swimming pools, there is a chlorine plant is there, and the chlorine is continuously supplied along with the water so that the water remains, because so many people are into the pool and they might carry some germ or something, and that is why for purification of the swimming pool also we use chlorine, right? Then next is non-metal used in the purple colored solution which is applied on wounds as antiseptics. Yes, it is. It is iodine, mother tincture, iodine tincture. That is iodine, which is a non-metal. Lastly, you must be loving it. Many of you might be loving the crackers, bursting crackers. So it is sulfur and phosphorus. Predominantly, it is the sulfur. Even the gunpowder and all the which is used, the ammunition, that also contains 10% of sulfur, which is a non-metal, right? So with this, we finish off this chapter. And they have certain doubts that the doctor reported iron deficiency in my body. Where is this iron in my body? Of course, Bujho. We need to tell Bujho that iron is present in our blood in the RBC for making the hemoglobin, right? And alright. Magnesium is also found in the plants. They absorb it through the soil as a form of the manure. So with this, children, we finish off this chapter. Let us discuss what is there. Which of the following can be beaten into the sheets? Of course, zinc here, because zinc is the metal, right? So these are the questions which you need to do it. And I have some more questions for you, and I'll be just showing you 5 questions. I'll read them out. Please write their answers in the comment section so that the lazy bums who are not working hard, who do not want to work hard, they will at least learn the answers, right? So let us do that and write the answers in the comment section. And in the exercise, if you don't understand anything, you can always ask me. Now, we have, yes, look at this. You can take screenshots to note down to keep the content, or you can write it into your copies. These are extra questions. This one is already given in your book. Which of the following can be beaten into thin sheets? Zinc. Next question is, which of the following statement is correct? I am not going to tell you this thing. You answer it. And answer it in the comment section. Then metals can be drawn into thin wires because, what is it? Right? So you have to find the answer. The best electrical conductor is, if you watch my video, I have told it to you. Right? So you have to watch the previous one, the part 1 video. And next is the non-metal which has very high melting point. See, even non-metals, exceptions are always there. And there is a non-metal which has a very high melting point. You need to find the answer. Fill in the blanks. Phosphorus is a very dash non-metal. It is there in the book. Metals are dash and dash. Metals are dash conductors of heat and dash. Class 6. You have studied it. Iron is dash reactive than copper. We just now we have studied it. And metals react with acids to produce which gas? See, every question right now I have read it out here just now. is discussed in the video. This video or for this chapter, part 1 video is also being created. So, watch both the videos. Write down these 8-9 answers are there in the comment sections. And get control, get command on this chapter. Then we shall begin the next chapter. Till then, happy learning, stay safe, stay healthy. Thank you.